64-year-old Ismail Mohammed is returning to his home in Palma for the first time since he and his family fled from the town and was grateful to find his house still standing. Noticing that Rwandan police personnel are patrolling his street, he was confident enough to start sweeping and getting ready for the return of his family, but could not call them on his phone to tell them the good news because he had no airtime, and was moved immeasurably when a Rwandan policeman offered him a calling card. I fled with my entire family because of the atrocities that were being committed, but kept a keen eye on what was happening here and listened to the news on the radio. I heard it being reported that Rwandan forces had come to this region and that they were capturing key locations like Mosiboa the Praia. I was very happy and decided to come here to see how things are and if what I was hearing was true. In a few days, I will return with my family, and I am truly happy to see Rwandan forces here. Others too have been eager for their government to give them the green light to return to their home areas, and none is ignorant of the role Rwandan security forces played in making it happen. I am happy that today I have been able to speak to the Rwandans that came to save us, because we were not sleeping at night, always troubled. Now we can sleep and we are happy. These are very tough forces that have silenced Al-Shabaab, that had become accustomed to ordering executions as they pleased. Now we no longer see them. We can now freely walk around our own town again, and had come to check on our homes. We are all full of happiness. The town of Palma sits on the coast of the Indian Ocean and was left devastated by the terrorists that once occupied it. Nevertheless, people want to return home as soon as possible to begin rebuilding and putting their lives back together again.